These fire altars are part of the Vedic rituals of Yajna as per Indian tradition. As per the ritual, altars with different shapes should have the same area. Instructions for masons to build these altars are detailed in the ancient text Shulbha Sutra, part of the Vedic literature of India. Shulbha means rope in Sanskrit language. Let us explore how masons did it around 600 BC with just a rope and straight stick. We will draw a square, circle, and semicircle whose areas are approximately the same. Equal areas are verified with the help of mustard seeds. Instead of rope, I will use compass for now to draw circles and ruler to draw lines. These shapes are drawn on a thick card sheet. Let us start with a straight line of arbitrary length. We'll draw a square with sides equal to this line. We'll equally divide the line with the help of a compass. This will be the radius of the circle which will be used to draw a square. Let us draw a vertical line passing through the center and bisect it again. With the same radius, we'll draw a circle with these four points as a center. Intersection points of these four circles are vertices of the square we want. Each side of the square is equal to the length of the line we started with. Our first shape is ready. Square. Now let us construct a circle which has the same area as that of a square. For that, we'll draw a circle with half of the diagonal as radius. On this vertical line, we will work A and B. Let us divide this line AB in three equal parts using a parallel lines method. This point is marked as R. Length AR is 2/3, while length RB is 1/3 of AB. We'll mark 1/3 of AB as R. With OR as a radius, let us draw a circle. Our second shape, circle, is ready. It has the same area as that of a square. Now we have a square and circle of the same area. How about a semicircle of the same area? We will take help of this square again. Diagonal of this square is root 2 times that of the side. Constructing a circle on the new square with this method will have twice the area of the current circle. And the semicircle of the new circle will have exact area of the current circle. We will use the same method to construct a square first and then the circle of the same area from the square. This circle has an area which is twice that of a square we started with, and semicircle, same area. Let us draw an earlier circle in the middle with the same radius. We have three shapes with equal area: square, circle, and semicircle. How can we verify that all these areas are same? With the help of a paper knife, we will cut all the three profiles. Now let us use mustard seeds. Thick card sheet profile can contain these seeds inside. We'll place this circular profile on a corrugated sheet as a base. Let us add seeds inside the circle till all the area is covered. just one layer of seeds. Tapping the base helps in equal distribution. Same quantity of seeds is used to verify areas of other two shapes. We can see that same quantity of seeds can cover different profiles completely. With this, we can say that areas of these profiles are approximately the same. Exploration of mathematical shapes and their constructions fascinated many civilizations, including Indian as well. Problem of squaring the circle was attempted by many. Indians came up with this solution almost 600 BC or maybe before that. However, in recent years, it was proved that it is not possible to make a circle and square of exactly the same area using only compass and straight edge. This method worked very well for the practical purpose they wanted to achieve during the rituals. Now that we have verified equal areas with approximations, let us find out how close our ancients were with current known value of pi. Let us take side of the square as 10 cm. Its area will be 100 square cm. Diagonal of the square is root 2 times 10 and radius root 2 times 5. Subtracting side from the radius gives us 2.07 cm and one third of it 0.69 cm. Radius of the circle we are interested in is 5.69 cm. If we consider value of pi as 3.14, area of the circle will be 101.67 square cm, which is pretty close to 100 square cm that of a square. If we consider radius of the circle and area of the square, value of pi comes out to be 3.08, which is very close to 3.14. Instead of mustard seeds, you can try this activity with small ball bearings as well. There will be still some space in between seeds or balls. But this method works well with whatever we have around. This method of checking for equal areas can also be used in other scenarios like Pythagoras theorem, Kepler's law of equal areas, and many more. Let us use compass and straight edge to trisect the line. I am not sure if this is also part of the Shulba Sutra. There could be many ways to trisect a line as well. We'll draw another segment at an angle starting from point B. use a compass to mark three equal segments. Join point C and A. Draw an arc near point C, which intersects the segments CB and CA. Draw a similar arc at other two points. Measure the distance between two points so that angle can be drawn at two other places with the same value. Joining these points result in a line parallel to CA. Thus, with this method, we can trisect a line. Thank you.